this time. Oh, we have this bridge scene open. Okay. How am I supposed to break these goddamn shields? Are you sure I was supposed to parry these guys? Oh, I just used the heavy one. Hold on. Did I get... Oh, wait. I thought I got the guy behind me. Okay, I did. Oh, no. I didn't. Alright, give me that shit. Oops. Yeah, whatever. Oh, what the hell? What the hell was that? Okay. And now it's time to do some running! Alright, alright. Come on, there we go. Ooh. Start tapping the wrong button there. You can actually fuck up this sequence really easily if you just... You gotta keep... You can't actually ninja run over these cars, because the ninja run is actually slightly too slow. So you have to, whatchamacallit, you have to actually manually jump them. Oh, come on! Okay, this lock-on is gonna kill me. Okay, well that didn't work. This is a really bad part because, well, again, the controls don't really support as precise movement as they probably wanted originally. And this sequence kind of requires very specific movement. Okay, now we got a dizzy helicopter. Oh, come on. And gotcha. That was really anticlimactic. This sequence, there's a way to do it stealthily, because there's a civilian down there, but I have absolutely no idea. It's kind of the idea, you climb up to this roof, you start attack that guy, and then you just... I don't know what you're supposed to do with those two. I know there's two gliders, so I have absolutely no idea how to do this stealthily, so... Oh, I still don't have to... Fucking... Ah! I keep trying to use combos that I don't have yet. And I'm trying to do this, this one, I don't know what the attack is actually called. It's this kind of, some kind of dive move. It's a really good startup for basically any combat sequence. Oh, fuck, I hope that's the one up. Did I get it? Okay, apparently I didn't get that one. Fine. Is that chest here? There is a chest here. Bonk. And now we run all the way here, just so we can run all the way back.
So that's where they're holed up.
Some kind of electronic lock on the gate.
Most likely, it opens only if you have the right ID data stored in your left hand. Perhaps you could find a cyborg with access and, borrow it?
You see any cyborgs around here, Doc?
Why not double back? Check the vehicle route again. You know, back at the entrance to the old city. Who knows? Maybe you can hitch a ride. Most likely platoon commanders carry correct ID data for the gate. Use enhanced mode to figure out who to hit.
Yeah, I know who I need to hit. And thank God this is the only part where you actually have to do this. And it's not these guys, don't you worry. I know exactly who it is I need to hit, so... I just need to make sure I'm not gonna fuck it up. That is actually, that sliding into the cutting is actually one of the best ways to cut off the hands. But unfortunately we're gonna have that opportunity with this guy. This is the guy I need to do it with. Completely identical to everybody else here. There we go. There we go. You just need to do a precise cut. It's much easier in the game because you have more fuel.
It appears that man underwent modification at the Patriot facility, just as you did.
Yeah, good to know. Because you get more fuel, because like I said, I almost ran out of there when I got that hit in, because you have to be so precise. One fuck up, and if you got the hand even slightly wrong, nope, you aren't getting that shit. It's frustratingly precise. These guys. Just give me a second here. Thank you. Prepare to see that a lot. That's basically most of the game. Most of the combat in this game is just that screen. Right, and I don't know, squeezing their innards out? I don't know what the hell do you even call that? Come on. Give me that. Nudie magazines. All the stealth items in this game are just completely useless. You never end up using them. Because there's no point. You're a walking blender. Why would you ever use stealth? Just why? There's really no point to it. Oh yeah, this scene. This is a pretty good scene. This is actually really fun. This was one of the first... Well, obviously the raid battle was what kind of win me over to this game. But this scene in particular, I just kind of... I cracked at this really badly when I originally played, because it's funny. This is really funny. Doesn't seem that funny right now, but there's a good joke in it. I don't have much to say right here. I'm just kind of watching it. I'm not really good at commentating on this game. I don't know what to say. Except that, it's good. It has its faults in the story, but... Raiden's reaction to that is great.
Raiden, what's happening? Your heart rate
spiked. Yeah, like I was saying, this game, it's hard to comment because I don't really have anything...
All right, I'm heading for the
whenever I'm playing the game, it's good. The gameplay is really good, it's solid. But whenever I'm watching the cutscenes, I'm like, the story is really bad. Because it's not a good story, it's full of cliches, and I know that's kind of the... Well, that kinda is like a thing with the Metal Gear series, but I don't know if that excuses anything. It's kind of... hard to say. I don't know. Ooh, hello. Oh yeah, I'm good. Awesome.
More classified Patriot information was in that man's holographic memory.
I have no idea. Why is stored in the left hand? I never really got that. Never clear about that. Like, why the left hand? Why always the left hand? What's so special about having a left hand? Oh, shut up. Oh, that's gonna fuck up the parry too early. Gotta delay it a bit with these things. Ah! Oh, come on! Okay, how am I not landing a single parry? I just realized, I haven't landed a single one. Like, I've blocked, but I have not landed a single successful parry. Because... I'm out of here. Nope, still not landing that. Oh, come on! I don't get it. How am I not landing a single one? How am I not landing single one of these? Oh, come on! What the fuck is going on? What is going on? Something's wrong. I don't get it. Like, something is absolutely wrong. I'm not landing one of these. I don't get it. I don't get it. Something's wrong here. I'm doing something. Either I'm absolutely fucking up with something, or I just don't remember how to do it. Because it's the same as blocking, right? It's tap forward and attack when they're attacking. If you time it right, you get the parry. And I'm using the same strategy I always do, which is basically you tap. There's an exploit into it. Then you just gotta keep tapping until. You just keep tapping so that you will always end up landing it, no matter what happens. So I don't get it. If I can still get you. Oh, I still got it! Damn! Still got it!
Bring me more, and maybe I can develop something interesting from
it. No idea how I did that. Yeah, I need to look into that. I'm doing something. I must be doing something wrong. Because
we intercepted call for
I doubt this game has a patch out that would fix something like that.
You can engage
like, it would have been fixed ages ago.
I'm above you!
Well, obviously I can test against these guys. If you're wondering why I'm running and doing light attacks constantly, it's because of the missiles. I can destroy them from midair. Damn it, get over here! Oh yeah, I need to do this dumb shit. Oh, I hate that you have to do this to the fucking helicopters for some reason. I don't know actually how I got it the previous helicopter. without doing this, because I usually have to do this in every single copter in the game. Even the exciting music is gonna end. Yes, the helicopters in this game are really anticlimactic. They're really boring enemies to fight. Because it's just this. You don't really do any combos on them. You just kinda wait for them to come to source range and they do this, and sometimes it works. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. And then you do a little bit of this. And then it's GG. Extremely boring. Open up. Let's proceed to the facility area, I think. Yep. Last section of this stage. Closing in on the boss.
Is the refinery's backyard.
So what? It's a sheer drop? The refinery's not connected to the city at all?
No.
Yeah, when you say it like that, it sounds really dumb.
There should be a narrow path around there that leads to the plant.
So what's the point of the plant if it doesn't connect to the city? Like, isn't that kind of the first things you do? You make sure the power plant has a way to supply, you know, power to the city? And, I mean, well, it is connected, right here, to this gate, so what they just said is, unless this is some, for some reason, not the power plant, which, if this isn't the power plant, I have no idea what actually is the power plant in this game, because this is the only place we go, we never see any other facility that could be the power plant.
Keep on coming.
Yeah. Try not to get fucked over by the geckos, so this is the strategy for the geckos. What I think these are dwarf geckos actually called. I don't know. But really don't care. My strategy for beating them is. Okay, hit it! There we go, some! I'll take it. I'm not much into precision cutting in this game, just kind of mashing it because it works better. Kill them faster. Okay, there was something. Oh, there's a chest over there. Whoop! Oh, come on, right, and get in there. Goody goody. Ryan is not obviously Ryan ain't a fan. Almost fucked up there. Almost had to fight one more enemy. Oh! Gotta watch out for those lasers. It's not like they do anything. Oh, that was easy. Okay, what was this?
Ryan, wait. There are active IR sensors in the area. Battle factory security, no doubt, but the enemy may be using it.
Where the hell do I put the... No. Oh, there we go. Okay, so there we go. Now I think we sold lasers, so Raiden knows how to jump them. There we go. Lasers avoided. Ah, my nose is itching. Oh, pardon me. Okay, so there's lasers. There's a camera over there. So we just do this. Is there lasers there? Oh, no lasers. And we're home free. Well, technically. We just need to kill this thing. And grab a few more. More of these guys. Oh, okay. I guess I didn't get it this time. Jesus! no workplace security in this. Oh god! I need to get out of here. Thank you. You don't want to go help. You're about to help. Oh god. No, I didn't get the hand. I just thought I got the hand, but whatever. It's not like I actually... I already have a save that I've collected. Oh, come on! Oh, Jesus! Get out of here! Come on. Okay, there we landed it. I have no idea what triggers it. I guess I'm just like... kind of missing it by just a second, so I don't know. Like it has to when I fuck it up, it has to be like a nanosecond or so. Because I've no other explanation for that. Because that strategy where you do it preemptively and you can keep tapping forward and attack constantly, even when you're just normally attacking, and that's why my controller makes such a terrible sound. It's because I constantly do that, because it keeps you free parries constantly. That's the strategy on kind of how to cheese your way against in this game, and it's just, I wouldn't normally do that, but it just kind of has stuck with me now, so can't really stop it anymore. Where's the guy? Here's the guy.
Nice hiding spot. Wonder where he learned that from.
Yeah, I wonder where he learned from. I don't know, maybe Kojima showed him. No, wait, Kojima... I don't remember if Kojima had anything to do with this game. Now it's just... like, I can't remember. Did he write the story for this? I mean, because if he did, I wouldn't be surprised, but if he didn't, that's where I'm gonna surprise, because this is all him. All of this is just absolutely purely Kojima. Or maybe it isn't. I haven't played other Metal Gears, so I've only seen some clips. I do have the, like I said, I do have the Phantom Pain, which might be a video at some point. At least me playing a little bit of it. And now we got the first... when you'd come, Jack the Ripper. The first of the Wings of Destruction. Where is he?
I can show you a better time than that, crusty old bear.
You're in charge here.
Oh, I doubt you can show me.
The cold wind of France. And you, your reputation precedes you. Liberian, but white as snow. A natural born killer, even as a child.
Hold on, she's a long time ago. She's French.
I was born in Algeria myself, you know. I'm only half French.
So they wanted a black chick, but they wanted her to sound like French, so
you see,
Algeria.
Cut from the same cloth, you and I.
You don't.
I see the connection there. I
lost my whole family, everything.
Why did she have to be French?
But I butchered those fuckers. My family's killers. That's when I realized I am a killer too, and a good one at that.
Yeah, we're gonna see how good you are at that. In Iraq. Seriously, in you are.
I'd found my calling.
A decent boss fight.
You're proud of that, are you?
What happened, happened. To be honest, I found it quite dull. My enemies fell like domino, one after another. Not once did I feel threatened. I was adrift, without challenge. Without purpose.
Well, yeah. Obviously, you wasn't threatened because you're enhanced the shit.
And then
obviously everybody died against you because you have improved yourself beyond humans and you were fighting normal humans. Yeah, if you wanted to challenge, you go up against, you know,
his ideas,
other cyborgs.
Ideals, Jack. What are yours?
I don't know.
I protect the weak.
Does that even technically count as an ideal? I mean, again, I'm English, not my first language, but protecting the weak.
So naive.
It's just.
And if I must kill to protect them, then so.
It's not even your, is it? I don't know.
It seems we have less in common than.
I have to go check Urban Dictionary. I'm sure I'll get the finest of answers from there.
If you would kill for your ideals, then surely you are ready to die for them.
Well, that's kind of the thing, you know. I can't get, like. Again, the dialogue in this game is not the best on all characters. Jetstream and Sundowner, those pretty much have the best dialogue. And one other character who I'm. Well, I think everybody knows who I'm talking about, but we'll get to him. Although that's kind of cool. And I do like her design. She has a really good design. Oh god. How the hell did I... How do you parry something like that? Oh shit. Let's get these bastards out of here.
Don't you want to be here?
Oh god. Nope. Jesus Christ. She's like a fucking Kingdom Hearts boss. Like, she reminds me of Marluxia or from Kingdom Hearts 2's Final Mix? Yeah, the special. The. Room of Remembrance fight. This is. She has a really similar moveset. Even though she's using a completely different weapon. But that just kind of. Explains how insane Marluxia's boss fight actually is. And I also do like this fight. Although this part is kind of weird. So what do you want? You want to get close? Or she's gonna stop. The hell was that? Oh, yeah, close. Okay. I do like she does use it kinda as a whip as well, and not just as a cane. Brandon's kind of lucky she doesn't do that cartwheel thing she did in the phase one in this one, because Brandon has no way to defend himself on that. Actually, what the hell doesn't he do that? What the hell, Mistral? You could have won the fight if you did that once during the phase two. But she has a completely different moveset during that. Well, she has a different moveset on this one as well, so. Jesus. Oh yeah, I can't stand. Oh my god! It up. I'm getting closer. Oh my god, how am I this bad? I've been playing this on easy mode lately, I don't know. Probably. That would explain this. My tremendous lack of skill in this fight. Actually, yeah, I think I was playing this last time on easy. When I played it. Bomb circle. Funny thing that the geckos do drop health, so I'm not. Because I know I can do this fight, no damage. And I've done this with the wooden sword once. So. No, twice, because I did the bosses with the wooden sword and. Then I did the okay, there we go. Smack. Jeez. Language, madame! That's the second F-bomb you have dropped. Bonk. I wanted to say that was easy, but it really. How the hell did I get an A? How the. Whatever, I understand. I guess you don't only get B if you die once. Or you take long.
So this is how they felt. Dying. For a cause.
Hold on!
I am sorry.
I never got this. How the hell they're. I know they're cyborgs. But how they're calling me after they've been chopped up to meat?
Like,
that's her! I don't see a phone in there. And. This would suggest none of them have. Actual, you know, human brains. They're all cybernetic brains. So they're just robots, then.
She's not talking to you, idiot.
You killed her!
It's just Lee's way to voice becoming more and more gravelly as we go on.
It's overdose, I am. Surrender.
How is it over? You killed somebody who obviously isn't really. Vital to his plan.
Surrender. We are exactly where I want.
Like, yeah, he
shit.
I don't know. I don't get this.
With Russia money to make Russia money. It is no plan for Abkhaz. It is their prison. But now they will be free.
I would have suggested other different plan, but again, I don't know. And my favorite thing, this never gets brought up. Never again in the game. This is. This doesn't matter. None of this matters.
We're sending a helicopter. Secure an LZ.
This never gets brought up.
Understood.
Nobody talks about this complete failure of a mission, by the way. This absolute massacre. Oh, I missed the combat sequence? And how the hell is it B? Oh yeah, oh, of course it is B, because if I miss it, it counts as the worst possible scene. So it runs up to the second lowest, which is... Wait, no, second lowest would be B, but it's only one B. There's more A's than there's one S, so how the hell is it B? I never got this. Yeah, whatever. The pole arm, completely useless. The only one we might be using is the one we get from Sundowner. Because that shit's... That's real shit right there. Okay. Give me the fear souls. I need that. Life. Oh, wait, give me that shit too. Okay. And then. This. Enhancements. Strength. Absorption. Energy. And then. Skills. Yeah. Okay. Aerial parry immediately. Offensive defense. This is the dodge. Sky high. Counter strike. I don't want that. I think we want that. I might as well get all. No. Oh, I don't need that. Oh, there's the falling lightning. There we go. We might as well get that too. I'm gonna do more. Lightning strike and quick draw isn't really important on where we want to save up. So, not save that. Then we have the costumes. The DLC costumes, we're not gonna be using those. I think they give something. Like, they give some boost or something, and this is the original. I don't care. Unique weapons, let's just check that shit out. This is that Mistral, Pole Arm, and whatever. Exit customization screen. Oh, we're getting this. Okay, well, we're getting this cutscene, and then we'll be ending this episode. It's kind of dumb. I can't really end the episode between. No, that there's no way to save the game really there and end it without crashing the game.
Relax, Kev.
So we're kind of getting always kind of a teaser for the next part.
Yeah. Well, just get into the sewer system ASAP.
Why is he dressed up
like
that?
Anyone who notices you will just mind their own business.
I don't get it. I just...
You sure you want the K-9000 there along for this one?
I had the good doctor make some adjustments along with the repairs.
Why? Why do they have to have their mangy dog?
So yeah, I say let's throw him a bone.
Just...
Wordplay, my exoskeleton resembles a K-9.
It's so K-9 dumb! I know Blade Wolf's awesome, but for fuck's sakes, why? In the first episode, I already made the comparison to the fucking Scooby Gang, and I'm not the first one to make that. But why do they need the dog? Why? A comic relief dog.
Why
does Raiden dress like that? I mean, it is the best skin in the game. You get it after the stage, but why? Oh, whatever. Oh yeah, and this line again.
Adios, amigos.
¿Viste? Qué raro, eh? Hay que hacer que no lo vimos. Vámonos ya.
If this wasn't me, if this wasn't Kojima, I have lost all faith in humanity. That there actually can be two people writing character dialogue this dumb.
Let's get started. Your mission's to investigate the Desperado-affiliated research center somewhere in that area. According to the intel from our client, the lab's been dumping illegal waste into those sewers. FYI, they're also involved with the cartels in human trafficking. Allegedly, anyway.
This just gets better and better.
Tell me about
it. I get more into this next episode.
Infiltrate the lab and find out everything you can.
If this is common knowledge about the Desperado,
the exact location.
So I'm looking for anywhere the lab might hook up with
this game gets really dumb later on because of this. Because that seems to be common knowledge.
Sneak into the lab and see if you can find evidence implicating them on anything.
And later on we'll find something out about Desperado.
We'll see.
And who they're working for, and that they're working for them is also common knowledge.
Maybe something related.
That these two combining just
like experimentation.
It's possible. First things first, though. Find a way into
this game gets dumb. I warned you. This is gonna get dumb. dark and dumb.
Live in those sewers, so you know, watch out.
Black crocodiles? Could they be talking about UGs?
Maybe just an urban legend. But still, be careful.
I will scout ahead.
This is the most massive sewer I've ever seen in my life.
Yes, sir.
I just realized how fucking huge this place is! What sewer is as wide as a fucking... I don't even know what they're called, like, the roads that... High road, whatever, I don't know. I don't know, whatever, we're ending this episode right now. I hope we're joined. Enjoyed my rambling. I don't know how long this is gonna be. I don't even care anymore. I hope you enjoyed. Please leave a like, leave a or dislike if you didn't like it. Leave a comment below if you have something to say, or you just want to call me a dumbass for not being able to land those parries in 10 times in a row. And hope I see you guys next time. Bye bye.